The 6S pyramid is used when doing research to answer evidence-informed decision-making, or EIDM, questions. This video tutorial will introduce the 6 levels of the 6S pyramid and the types of resources you will find at each level. I will describe the levels of the pyramid beginning from the bottom and work my way up. This illustrates the process through which a piece of evidence becomes identified as a strong evidence-based source. When searching, you will begin at the top and work your way down. The bottom level of the pyramid is single studies. These are primary, original research studies in which the authors designed and conducted the research. A common example of a single study is the randomized controlled trial. The methods section for a single study research article will include the study design, for example, randomized controlled trial, a description of the type of research subjects involved, or the population, the intervention, or what the subjects were asked to do, how the data was collected, and so on. The next level of the pyramid is synopses of single studies. A synopsis is a summary or abstract. In this case, what is being summarized is one single study. Some advantages of a synopsis are that the single study had to be of high quality before it would be included in an abstracting journal. It's short. What you see on the screen is the full synopsis, and in most cases, it will include commentary written by a professional in the field who will give real-world application to the information provided in the study. When searching for an answer to a qualitative or PS question, begin searching at the synopses of single studies level of the pyramid. We can see that the label of randomized controlled trial has been applied to this abstract. Please note that the reference provided in the synopsis is not the reference that you should include in your assignment. It is for the original study that is summarized here. You should reference the synopsis that you found and used. We have a methods section describing how the research was conducted, and we find our commentary here as well. This image zooms in on the methods portion of the synopsis. Here we can see that the researchers conducted a randomized controlled study in which neonates were randomized to either the control, swaddling, or heel warming group. It goes on to provide further details about the methods used, but these are clues that indicate that primary, original research was conducted, meaning that this is a synopsis of single study. The next level of the pyramid is syntheses, more commonly referred to as systematic reviews. The research process for systematic reviews involves finding existing studies. This is known as secondary research, rather than conducting primary original research, like single studies. They're called systematic reviews because there is a very systematic approach as to how they're carried out. There is usually a team of researchers. Prior to searching, they will decide upon selection criteria that will guide which studies are included and which studies are excluded from the review. For example, if they are only interested in randomized controlled trials, all other studies would be excluded. Next, they will conduct a systematic and thorough search of the databases that have been identified as relevant for their research question. Two or more reviewers will independently screen the results, first examining the titles and abstracts to quickly eliminate non-relevant studies. They will then go through the remaining studies, applying the selection criteria. The review will summarize and synthesize evidence from the selected studies, provide practice recommendations if there is enough high-quality evidence, or point out areas that require further research to strengthen the evidence. Systematic reviews frequently contain meta-analysis, which is a statistical combining of data across the studies included in the review. The results will be displayed in the form of a forest plot. In this example, the methodology is broken down into several categories: a description of the search process that was followed, the selection criteria that determined what studies were included, and the data collection and analysis that describes how two authors independently screened abstracts and assessed the full text of articles. Note the critical appraisal that has taken place up to this point as a single study has moved up the pyramid to Synopses of Single Studies, Syntheses, and now we move on to Synopses of Syntheses. In the same way that Synopses of Single Studies summarize single studies, a Synopses of Synthesis summarizes one systematic review. As we discussed with Synopses of Single Studies, there are some advantages to a synopsis. It's short. What you see on the screen is the full synopsis. The systematic review had to be of high quality before it would be included in an abstracting journal. And in most cases, it will include commentary written by a professional in the field who will give real-world application to the information provided in the systematic review. There are also some disadvantages when it comes to synopses of syntheses. The process for conducting, writing, and publishing a systematic review can take upwards of 2 years, so the information presented may not be the most current information available. Consider also checking for single studies that will update the information provided in the systematic review. We can see that the label of systematic review has been applied to this abstract. Remember that the reference provided in this synopsis is not the reference that you should include in your assignment. It is for the original systematic review that is being summarized here. You should reference the synopsis that you found and used, in this case, evidence-based nursing, not Annals of Internal Medicine. We have a methods section describing how the research was conducted, and we find our commentary here as well. Here we are zooming in on the methods section from the example of a synopsis of synthesis presented on the previous slide. We can see a list of databases that were searched: Medline, PsycINFO, DARE, and Cochrane. And we can see that two investigators independently reviewed abstracts and full-text articles against the pre-specified inclusion criteria. It goes on to provide further details about the methods used, but these are indicators that secondary research was conducted, meaning that this is a synopsis of synthesis. Our examples of synopses of single studies and synopses of syntheses both come from a journal called Evidence-Based Nursing. This makes it important to be able to identify what kind of synopsis you have found. There are a few clues we can use to help with this. The label at the top of the page: randomized controlled trial versus systematic review. The reference provided. If it comes from Cochrane database of systematic reviews, we know that it is a synopsis of synthesis. If the source is a journal, it could be either a single study or a systematic review that is being summarized. Our examples reference Journal of Clinical Nursing and Annals of Internal Medicine as the sources, neither of which gives us a clear indication of the source type. The methods. This section will describe exactly how the research was conducted. This is the most reliable method to determine what kind of source you have found. If it describes primary original research, for example, a randomized controlled trial, it will be summarizing a single study. If it names databases that were searched, selection criteria, and the number of independent reviewers who applied the selection criteria to the results, these are all indicators that a systematic review is being summarized. Our next level is summaries. At this level of the pyramid, evidence was gathered and synthesized from all the lower levels of the success pyramid, with an emphasis placed on systematic reviews, where sources have already been critically appraised. Based on the available evidence, recommendations were made for clinical practice. Some examples of summaries are clinical practice guidelines and evidence-based textbooks. When you are searching for an answer to a quantitative question, you begin searching at the summaries level of the pyramid. You may be accustomed to seeing the RNAO best practice guidelines online, but they also come in print format, and you will find most of the guidelines available in the Conestoga Library Collection. Near the front of the book, you will find a summary of recommendations, which gives short recommendations that may answer your question. Each recommendation is given a number. You will use this number to find the corresponding discussion of evidence. Each recommendation is also assigned a level of evidence. To understand the levels, look for the legend either before or after the summary of recommendations. We move further back in the book to the practice recommendations section and look for the relevant recommendation number. The recommendation is restated, the level of evidence is indicated, and then there is a discussion of evidence. Within the discussion of evidence, there will be citations for the sources that provided the evidence to develop the recommendation. Remember that these sources may also be helpful to you and give you more in-depth information as you conduct your research. Finally, at the top of the success pyramid, we find systems. Systems are computerized decision support systems that integrate an individual patient's electronic health record with evidence from all the lower levels of the pyramid, leading to a tailored clinical recommendation for a specific patient. Systems are not widely available, but even if they were, there would be issues that would prevent us from using them for EIDM research, such as privacy, access, patient specificity, and so on. Although we can't use systems when conducting EIDM research, this would be the optimal source of evidence for clinical decision making. This version of the 6S pyramid recaps what we have discussed in this video, including brief notes and examples for each level of the pyramid, as well as advantages and disadvantages for the synopsis levels. Remember that when researching a quantitative PICO question, begin at the summaries level of the pyramid. When researching a qualitative PS question, begin at the synopses of single studies level. This concludes this video tutorial introducing the 6 levels of the success pyramid.